Just like traditional aircraft, each vehicle needs to be approved by the FAA, in order for it to start flying regular passengers. The FAA is in charge of regulating all aspects of aviation, from traditional passenger airlines to commercial space travel. Since space vehicles share the same airspace as airliners, the FAA is responsible for making sure everything is carried out safely, and that the public are protected. But the FAA's involvement with air travel is very different to space travel. To put it into perspective, the FAA handles around 16.5 million flights per year. In the space world, the number of launches expected to take place this year is around 50. But now that space tourism is becoming a real thing, this number will start to grow rapidly in the next few years. Not to mention SpaceX's grand plan for suborbital passenger travel using their Starship rocket. They want to operate offshore launch platforms all around the globe, with thousands of passengers traveling each day. With the FAA's current rules, this would be impossible. If you're an American entity launching a rocket anywhere in the world, you need an FAA license. But getting a license isn't a quick process. Once a company files an application, it can take the FAA up to 180 days to review it. This process involves a huge amount of testing and verification before they can give the all clear. The assessment is broken down into four different regulatory parts, each with their own set of strict safety requirements. This week, the U.S. Federal Communications Commission granted SpaceX a license to communicate with Starship via ground-based antennas to receive data during the first orbital flight test, set to occur early next year. According to the FCC filing, SpaceX targets to conduct the orbital flight before March 1, 2022. However, the company is still pending regulatory approval from the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration, that is currently performing an environmental review of the Starbase launch site, in South Texas, to ensure safe spaceflight operations. SpaceX will be able to apply for an FAA spaceflight license once the environmental assessment is complete. Deadline is December 31st. The FCC application shows the orbital launch could take place anytime between December 20, 2021 and March 1, 2022, from SpaceX's testing facility in Boca Chica, Texas. However, the Musk-led company still needs to wait for the Federal Aviation Administration to complete its environmental assessment before Starship can leave the ground. The FAA announced in November that it would complete the review on December 31st, which means SpaceX has all the regulatory approvals needed to send its massive rocket into space. The news, however, may not be a surprise to Musk, who has continuously said a launch was possible by January 2022. Speaking during an online meeting held by the U.S. government's national academies, Musk said the first orbital launch of Starship, which he called a very profound vehicle, that's making very rapid progress, would hopefully happen in January, or perhaps February 2022, and could be followed by 12 or more launches throughout the rest of next year. We're close to our initial orbital launch, he said. The first orbital flight we're hoping to do in January. The news, however, may not be a surprise to Musk, who has continuously said a launch was possible by January 2022. There's a lot of risk associated with this first launch, Musk said. So I would not say that it is likely to be successful, but I think we will make a lot of progress. Thursday's news now puts SpaceX one step closer to hitting Musk's January goal. The FCC application states, trajectory data of the orbital flight will be provided directly to NTIA, USAF and NASA. But now, SpaceX needs the green light from the FAA. The company told the FCC that its objective for the first orbital flight test is to collect as much data as possible during flight. To quantify entry dynamics and better understand what the vehicle experiences in a flight regime that is extremely difficult to accurately predict or replicate computationally, SpaceX said. This data will anchor any changes in vehicle design or concept of operations after the first flight and build better models for us to use in our internal simulations. The assessment looks at environmental impacts of SpaceX's initial mission profile, and reviews debris recovery, local road closures in Boca Chica, Texas, where the firm's launch site is located, and other issues. The Starship program aims to develop vehicles for the interplanetary travel of cargo and humans to the Moon, Mars and beyond. However, the Musk-led company still needs to wait for the Federal Aviation Administration to complete its environmental assessment before Starship can leave the ground. To perfect the rockets, SpaceX plans to conduct several test launches over the next few years, all of which will require a permit or vehicle operator license from the FAA. Although Musk seemed appreciative of the FAA's timeline, the billionaire has not always been happy with the agency. In January, he bashed the FAA on Twitter for its rules regarding space launches that caused a delay in SpaceX launching its Starship serial number 9 rocket. Which is fine, the FAA space division has a fundamentally broken regulatory structure, Musk tweeted. Their rules are meant for a handful of expendable launches per year from a few government facilities. Under those rules, humanity will never get to Mars. The FAA has stayed quiet while Musk airs his frustrations online, but the division told DailyMail.com in January, "We will continue working with SpaceX to resolve outstanding safety issues before we approve the next test flight." Although not stated by the FAA, the delay may be due to SpaceX's previous test flight of its Starship SN8, that traveled about 7 miles into the air and then exploded on the launch pad, in what Musk called an awesome test. The review is over SN9's crash landing on February 2. SpaceX eventually launched its SN9 for its first high-altitude test. But the massive rocket was unable to maneuver into the vertical position, before landing on the launch pad and exploded upon landing. A month later, the FAA announced it would oversee the investigation of the SN9's crash landing, on February 2. Musk again went to battle with the FAA in July, as the agency warned SpaceX that its environmental review of a new tower, at its Boca Chica launch site in Texas, is incomplete and the agency could order SpaceX to take down the tower. With the last FAA review, the agency will have to determine if a finding of no significant can be issued, or it needs to perform a more intense review, an environmental impact statement that would ground the Starship even longer. Engineers are working to develop a fully reusable Starship launch system. The orbital flight will provide data to improve its design. "I think it is a very profound vehicle," Musk said about Starship. "I don't think anything like it is being developed. And I don't think anything quite like it has even been proposed, but it has the potential to affect human destiny in a very good way." Musk says Starship will enable NASA astronauts to build a permanent base on the moon, and he hopes the launch system could help humanity build the first sustainable settlement on Mars, to create a second home for our species. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.